Hello, everybody. My name is Angela Breda, and I have had the privilege of being one of the directors for this Christmas play that you guys are about to watch. And so I just wanted to come up and say a few words. First, I'd like to thank all of the parents of the kids that are going to be in this performance. Thank you all for trusting us with your children. These kids have been practicing since October, and so I thank you for bringing them to these practices and encouraging them to use the gifts that God has given them to bless the others that are in this room right now. And thank you for encouraging them to learn their lines and the songs and the motions and all the things that go into a play like this. We really appreciate all of your support. And I would like to thank our parent volunteers. I could not do this play without them. And so we have everybody listed in the bulletin who helped us out. I hope I didn't forget anybody. But there's been just a slew of people who have helped us out along the way. And so I thank you for that. And then I want to thank all of you for giving us this slice of time that we can share the most beautiful story ever told in a fun and lighthearted way, but we understand the gravity of the words that we are speaking. Our play today is from the perspective of the donkey that Mary rode in on. And so it may be unique, you may never have heard it from this perspective before, but we understand that this is the story of Jesus and the story of his beautiful birth. And if you are new to NCF, I know that we passed out flyers at the Carthage Parade that we invited people here. And so if that is you and you are new here, if this is the first time that you're ever hearing this story, I encourage you to come back and really just become a part of this church family, because we would love to have you. And it is no coincidence that you are here today. And so I just thank you, thank you, thank you for the opportunity to be able to tell this beautiful story of our Savior. And so without further ado, let me introduce some of our kiddos. And we've got the Covenant Kids Choir, which their names are all listed in your bulletin. They will be joining us soon with a triumphant entry. And so, but they are patiently-ish waiting in the NPR for their time to shine. But we've got John on our violin, and we've got Kaylin on our cello. Good job, guys. And then we have Mary being played by Rowan, and Joseph is being played by Brand. And then we've got some of Mary's friends who are going to be asking some questions soon. We've got Millie and Kayla and Addie and Callie and Ainsley and Audrey and Lily. All right, and then we have our caretaker, Nathaniel, and our donkeys, Wesley, Grayson, and Tate. All right, if you wouldn't mind, bow your heads, and I'll go ahead and pray us into this beautiful performance. Dear Heavenly Father, please, God, calm the nerves. Calm the nerves that are on this stage right now, and help us to just focus on you and the reason that we are telling this story. Thank you for sending us your beautiful son in this most humble of ways. And thank you, God, for just blessing all of these children and their families. Thank you for giving us this opportunity to plant seeds that your beautiful Holy Spirit can water. God, I ask that you soften the hearts of all of the people in this room, that they can receive this message, that they can hear from you, that they feel that you are drawing them in to your goodness, your faithfulness, your love. Thank you, God. Bless the rest of this performance, God. Please be with each and every child. Help them to feel your presence up here on this stage. Thank you, Lord. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Hi, my name is Jack the Donkey.
That's my name, too.
You don't say. All male donkeys are called Jack.
That's my name, three.
I'm trying to tell a story. When Jesus was born, there wasn't any nice rooms for him to stay in, so his mom laid him in a manger.
Like the one we eat from?
You mean like this one?
Yep, I was right beside that manger. So you might say, I was the first Jack in the box at Christmas.
Oh, brother.
My Christmas journey started in Nazareth. Jesus hadn't been born yet, but his birth was really close. Mary and Joseph needed my help.
Your help?
Listen, they needed my help to travel from there to Bethlehem to register for a census.
A census?
A census is where all people are counted.
Weird.
Right? Anyways, for their size, donkeys are stronger than horses, so I was able to carry Mary on my back for a long distance with no problem.
Mary was also carrying a special load herself.
You know, most people look down on us donkeys because, well, we are short, especially you.
Yeah, they literally have to look down.
Hey, I'm right here.
I bet it was easier to get on and off a donkey than a horse with that baby in her belly.
Not just any baby, this one was special.
I wonder if Mary knew that her baby would calm a storm with his hand.
I wonder if Mary knew her baby would walk on water.
I wonder if Mary knew her baby would bring the dead back to life.
I wonder if Mary knew her baby walked where angels trod.
Based on Old Testament scripture, Mary knew her baby would be the Savior, heaven's perfect lamb.
Yes, but do you think Mary would have ever thought she'd be giving birth to God's Son, the Son of the Most High, in a stable, placing him in a manger?
Scripture states that she found favor with God, treasuring up all things, pondering them in her heart.
The angel Gabriel came to Mary and told her, "Greetings, O favored one. The Lord is with you. Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. Behold, you will conceive in your womb and bear a son, and you shall call his name Jesus. He'll be great, and you'll be called the Son of the Most High. And our Lord God will give to him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over the house of Jacob forever, and over his kingdom there will be no end."
Behold, I am a servant of the Lord. Let it be to me according to your word.
Your baby boy, when one day walk on water, he
It took at least 4 days. 4 days for us to get to Bethlehem.
I bet you packed lots of snacks on such a long trip, especially in the dry land with no convenience stores.
I can eat almost any plants I find, and I did just fine eating what grew in the desert. Anyways, when we got through the desert to Bethlehem, there wasn't any nice rooms for Mary and Joseph to stay inside. This was fine by me. I was happy to be with all the other animals.
Sounds about right.
Donkeys do not like to be alone. I get along great with goats and sheep, too.
I bet you do.
And I'm also protective in nature and would guard baby Jesus and the other animals if given a chance. Back to the story. Not too long after we got there, baby Jesus was born. Some shepherds were nearby when an angel came to them. It scared them something fierce.
That would have scared me something fierce, too.
But the angel told them,
"Fear not, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. For unto you was born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord."
Stop videoing.
And this will be the final baby wrapped in swaddling cloths and lying in a manger.
Thank you.
Then a bunch of other heavenly hosts appeared with the angel shouting, "Glory to God in highest heaven and peace on earth to those with whom
God is pleased."
Now, speaking of scared.
Oh no, what?
I must let you know something else about donkeys. We don't scare as easily as horses do. And we're also very intelligent.
Yeah, we sure are.
We.
Instead of running away from danger like horses tend to do, we will run down a predator or make him go away with a strong, well-aimed kick.
Yeah, let's get back to the story about baby Jesus.
Okay, the shepherds made their way to Bethlehem to find Jesus. They found Jesus just as the angel had told them, lying in a manger.
What happened next?
The shepherds were so excited, they went to spread the word about Jesus. They told the good news to all who would hear. You know, us donkeys, we can hear each other from up to 60 miles away, FYI.
Huh?
You don't listen to anything. Thank you for letting me tell you about the birth of Jesus. I bet all you thought I could say was, hee-haw, 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 hee-haw.
Do as the shepherds did and share the good news with everyone. God wants everyone to know about his son, Jesus. Let us all stand and sing together, "Joy to the World."
You can be seated. Let's give them one more round of applause. What a great job. Let's thank our musicians for doing such a wonderful job. I told someone this morning, it's been hard to get into Christmas spirit. Now it's done, right? See a children's play like that. You know, we just want to, as we leave, as the children are getting ready and as you're preparing maybe to leave the room, we just want to remind you of what joy is. Everybody say, "Joy to the World." That's a wonderful song. If you've been here for the last couple of weeks, you know, we've on Sunday mornings, we've been talking about different songs. We talked about good Christian men rejoice and how we have reason to rejoice and give a mighty ruah, right? A blast of praise unto the Lord. Last week, if you were here, we talked about deck the halls. And sometimes it's not such a fa-la-la-la-la moment, you know. And Today, I want to just talk about, as we leave, this joy to the world. Just real quick, what is that? I want you to know that at Christmas time, it seems like we talk about joy a little more, don't we? We sing about it, we discuss it, we talk about it. But it's only appropriate. You see, I believe the world did not know joy until Emmanuel came. When Emmanuel was given, then the world could understand a joy that had never been. And I think it's important for us to realize that he is the one who brought true joy into the world. And in Galatians 4:4, it says, in the fullness of time that God sent forth his son. And I believe in the fullness of time, when the world was most desperately in need of joy, God sent Jesus. I'll remind you of a verse in John chapter 14, verse 27. And this is a very sad night, if you would, on as far as the followers of Jesus. They were in the upper room taking the Last Supper, and Jesus had told them that he was going to have to depart. But then this verse in 27, it's almost like a benediction. He says, my peace I leave with you. Everybody say, my peace. Now, I want to give me a little bit of leeway here, a little bit of room to work with this. I want to juxtapose the word joy in there. My joy I leave with you. My peace I leave with you. My love, my hope. See, Jesus brought things to the world that the world did not know. They didn't know the depth of love. They didn't know the depth of peace. They didn't know the depth of what hope was, and especially didn't know what joy is. Joy is having a sense of well-being despite the circumstance. And we saw Jesus live joy, didn't we? He knew he was born to die, and yet he lived a life of joy. Joy in the relationship between him and the Father. And I think it's so important for us to understand that we're to live in joy. As Jesus was joy to the world needs to know joy. And let me just give you a couple things here to remember as we leave, because we're leaving in just a few moments. The Word of God says in Isaiah chapter 61 in verse 10 that we are clothed in salvation. And if you remember the verse of King David, he says, "Joy, Lord, restore to me the joy of my salvation." So joy in our salvation is a part of our clothing. So we who are in Jesus Christ, who are sons and daughters of the Most High God, we're clothed with joy, a well-being despite our circumstances. See, this clothing allows us to accomplish our twofold mission. And we talked about this back in the summer and earlier in the year, that the twofold mission of the church, which, by the way, if you're born again, you're a part of the church. When you're born again and gifted with the Holy Spirit, then you immediately become a part of God's church, because the church is God's vessel or purpose here on earth. And we are clothed with certain things, if you would, that only Jesus could give us, that allows us to accomplish our purpose. Our first purpose is to advance the kingdom of God, right? And we do that here by believers developing other disciples who go out and disciple others. We come together to worship, to receive strength, and to be reminded that you are clothed in joy. Joy is the fragrance that goes before you. It is the beauty of these Christmas plays where we come together and we realize the depth of our joy. Our joy is found in heaven. It's not found in earth, but we live according to heavenly steps. Amen? So we're clothed in joy to advance the kingdom. Another thing I want to remind you of, our second purpose in this, is to hold back evil, or to stand against the gates of hell so they do not prevail against the world. And you're clothed for that. If you remember in Ephesians chapter 6, it says that we have certain armament, clothing. You know, we're clothed with the gospel that's on our feet, and the belt of truth, and the breastplate of righteousness. We carry a shield of faith and a sword of the word, and we have a helmet of salvation. What does David pray about his salvation? Restore the joy of our salvation. So if salvation covers our head and it's joy, then we also have joy in our righteousness that comes only from Christ. The Word of God we have joy in. At faith we have joy in. Truth we have joy in. And the gospel we have joy in. So I'm going to end with this. When we sing joy to the world, as Christ was joy to the world, you're joy to the world. You must go out clothed in joy, because the world does not know what you have. Amen. Everyone's together on three. Joy to the world. One, two, three.
Joy to the world.
That's who you are. Let's stand to our feet. Father, we thank you for this time together. This beautiful play, this beautiful reminder, God, of the simple gospel message is that you loved us enough to come and dwell among us. It all begins with that. The knowledge of God begins with the birth of Emmanuel, the Word of God become flesh. We thank you for this story, for this reminder, for the beautiful faces and the beautiful voices that sang that reminder to us today. And Lord, as we go out with our hearts full, may we be clothed in joy. We are joy to a lost and dying world. Help us to walk in a manner worthy of the clothing that you have so graciously given us. Now, Lord, transform us, Lord, from an audience of hearers to an army of doers, and help us to go out and to advance your kingdom while we hold back evil and doing it all clothed with heavenly garments. We thank you, God, in all things in Jesus' name. And the church says amen and amen. Thank you for coming today. Let's give everybody a round of applause again. What a great job they did. Have a great day.